This is the XbotGo Chameleon, a sports tracking AI cameraman made to follow, record, and broadcast games with the assistance of your phone. The core idea here is you set up this device on a tripod in the middle of a field, hit record, and it'll do the job for you. Ideally, it will rely on AI to follow and track the flow of a sports game. But unlike the XbotGo Gimbal we reviewed last year, the Chameleon uses its own built-in camera to track a game. In theory, this should result in more accurate and responsive camera tracking since it won't rely on the quality of a phone camera. But in practice, that seems to be not the case. I tested the Chameleon in two scenarios, a basketball game indoors and a basketball game outdoors. Here in the Philippines, we are hardcore basketball fans, but it's actually hard to cover an official full-court game, and the results were a mixed bag. In an indoor scenario, the lighting conditions were challenging as the court was only relying on ambient lighting from the windows. Since we don't have any idea what the Chameleon's camera sees as the app doesn't let us see it, it's harder to gauge whether it is struggling to see in low-light conditions. However, to XbotGo's credit, the Chameleon managed to track the game as quickly as it could despite the limited lighting, the limited angle on the left side, and the shaking flooring of the court from time to time. It wasn't the best scenario, but I happened to experience the best recording compared to when I took it outdoors. More on that later. The main takeaway here though is that the panning and the zooming are not as smooth as I would like, given you have this huge device mounted on a tripod. I was expecting better smoothness than their gimbal version, but instead, you get sudden panning and zooming. In an outdoor scenario, it's a lot brighter with better exposure to the court. However, I had no choice but to position the Chameleon backlit, which I thought played a role in tracking accuracy because, for the most part, the Chameleon was a step late in tracking the game. There were times when it couldn't track the ball, so it would immediately be switched to the closest players on the camera. I even switched between my Xiaomi 14 and iPhone 13 Pro Max just to see if it would do any better. But then again, the quality of the phone camera didn't matter because the Chameleon has its own camera. Basically, that's how the Chameleon worked in my testing. What you didn't see on camera was the amount of setup I needed to do to make the Chameleon work. The manual and the app give concise instructions to allow for the best tracking, which involves a sturdy tripod in the middle of the court. There is no calibration needed or even a setting to adjust the Chameleon's movements other than securing your phone onto the mount, which is handy, I must say, since it's built in. After setting all that, my first few recordings during the indoor testing were failures. For some reason, the Chameleon wouldn't go to the left and kept tracking the right side of the court to the point where it kept tracking the people on the sidelines. It only took a restart though for the device to work properly. The Chameleon supports over 20 plus sports to track, but most of them are in beta mode, so expect imperfect tracking. XbotGo also added a new follow me mode if you wish to record yourself playing a game or maybe just for social media content, using either the back or the front camera. Then again, it's also in beta mode, and I wasn't able to make it work properly even after a couple of software updates. On top of that, you're capped at 1080p at 30 frames, wherein in other modes, you can go up to 4K 30. Some features are missing, at least in basketball mode, such as jersey tracking and team sports tracking. The latter basically lets you select a specific player to track. Compared to the gimbal, the Chameleon has longer working times, higher recording resolution, and ultra-wide angle support. It's rated to last up to 8 hours, but the charging time to go from 0 to 100 is a painful 4 hours at 10 watts, which is really slow. The Chameleon has several bundles, but the standard starter pack includes a remote controller already for a price of $339 US, or almost 20,000 pesos when roughly converted. In the Philippines, expect the cost to go higher once you apply customs fees and taxes. The most expensive package costs $569 or around 33,000 pesos and includes their very own T1 and T4 tripod. You can check the links below if you're interested. The remote controller may come in handy to some, which I think is most useful when recording yourself. So basically, you have the directional and shutter buttons as well as several modes. You can either take a photo, record videos, control the camera angle, and mark certain clips during recording, which you can then turn into a highlight reel later on through the built-in video editor of the XbotGo app. Even with the AI and the dedicated device and processor baked into the Chameleon, it's not the perfect alternative to a professional cameraman. You definitely don't want to use this for professional use, but you can definitely use it for casual use. For example, recording practice games of your friends or your kids. If you can somehow deal with the quirks and master the use of the Chameleon and its app, I think there's some value to this, especially since most of the recording is done automatically. But that's it for this one. Drop a sub or like if you feel like supporting the channel. And as always, until the next one, stay safe. Thank you.